So this is my 2024 iPad mini 7, and unlike a lot of iPad videos out there, I don't use this as my primary computer or for school, for illustrations and 3D graphics or anything like that. Similar to a lot of other iPad owners, this is just my casual tablet that's a secondary device to my main laptop and phone. So yeah, I don't do anything crazy here, but I have things set up in certain ways that makes my iPad a very functional and efficient complementary device for my day-to-day use and sometimes even for productivity. If that sounds like what you want too, I hope this very simple video can help you out, and if it does, please consider subscribing to the channel. We're getting pretty close to 50k, and I would really appreciate it if you could help us out there. Since I don't do too much with my iPad, I try to keep things as clean and minimal as possible, not adding any unnecessary elements and keeping things as efficient and functional as I can. To double down on that, starting with the lock screen, I'm going for a general monochrome look and feel with this clean black and white wallpaper I got from Unsplash. And I set the date and time to this gray and thin font to match. As you can see, I don't have any widgets or icons here either. I used to have the weather and calendar widgets here, but I realized I almost never looked at them and ended up just going to the home screen anyway. So my home screen, of course, follows the same look, and it's just a single page with some glanceable widgets, dock at the bottom, app library on the right, and the today view on the left with a few more widgets. So the three widgets on the main home screen are my calendar, Google Tasks, and Microsoft 365. The calendar widget is from an app called MiniCal. It's got the perfect, minimal, yet informative look that I needed on the home screen to see what's coming up on my monthly schedule. It syncs with my Google Calendar, so everything crosses over seamlessly from all my other devices. And then to see the things I need to get done today or soon, I have the Google Tasks widget here, which I use super often. It's the perfect to-do app for me since it's also integrated with Google Calendar and just keeps my entire life organized. So it's really helpful for this little widget to show what's coming up, and it's also a really easy way to open up the app. Microsoft 365 being here might seem a little off-putting, but I do all my script writing on Word, and I use my iPad a bunch to review recent scripts and sort of as a teleprompter for my narrations. So it's really convenient for me to have this widget here showing my most recent document so I can quickly open it. On top of all that, all three of these widgets work out well for the monochrome look I'm going for, and they all transition nicely even when turning over to dark mode, so I like that. Now for the few widgets I need that don't really fit the look, I hide them over here in the today view so I can still check them whenever I want to, even from the lock screen. I also try to keep the bottom dock with as little apps as possible so it doesn't look so cramped. I still have a ton of apps installed here, including my messaging apps, streaming apps, and games, but those aren't my number one priority for my iPad usage, so they're okay to be a couple taps away. The only apps I have here are the ones I need really quick from any app or screen, so I can put them in full view, split view, or as a slide over app. More than anything, I watch tons and tons of YouTube while checking emails or reading articles and threads. If I'm mostly focused on reading or just browsing, I just pop out Spotify and listen to some lo-fi jazz while doing that. Since it is annoying to tap and swipe over things so often, I really like taking advantage of slide over apps. Really easy to reach, swipe them in, and switch between apps. I love using this for apps I need really often or never want to close. Always make sure to keep Spotify, Gmail, and Google Calendar here. Whatever I'm doing, either watching YouTube, browsing, or watching movies, I can quickly check for any alerts and changes without having to interrupt myself. As for the control center, I try to follow the same design language with just a single page of the most essential controls. The most often used controls towards the bottom for easy thumb access, and the lesser used ones towards the top. I know iPadOS 18 totally revamped Control Center with multiple pages of big controls, but I personally think less is more here. By the way, if you're wondering what case this is the Urban Magnetic iPad case by Banks. It's just around $30, but I love how this folio case looks and feels. Super sleek and minimal while also feeling premium. It's got this really nicely textured PU leather material on the outside and soft microfiber on the inside to keep your display glass nice and clean. Auto wake and sleep is supported. The magnetic flap also works as a holder for the Apple Pencil, which I don't have. The cover acts as a kickstand and folds into some interesting angles. It's not the most flexible since there's only 4 fixed angles, and I'm not a fan of the vertical one since it always looks a little bit slanted, but I use this one for gaming and for watching YouTube every breakfast, and this other one for using as a sidecar for my monitor. Of course, this is a mini, so it doesn't have much screen real estate for a desktop environment, but it's like a perfect little sidekick monitor for my main one. I always have Spotify, Google Calendar, and my messaging apps here. The things I always need open but don't really want to be switching to them all the time. But thanks to the size, it stays nicely under my monitor without taking much of my attention, so I actually really like that. I gotta give props to Apple here for making Sidecar so easy to use. I just find it in my Mac Control Center and it just works, so I love that. I don't do a ton of gaming here, but when I do, it's mostly with a wireless Xbox controller. Since the case acts as a kickstand, I don't really bother with attachable controllers, so that's why my old Xbox controller is still the king in this use case. I'm trying to break into AAA gaming here with games like Assassin's Creed Mirage and Death Stranding, but it's still a really limited category on the App Store, so I mostly do my iPad gaming, reliving my Call of Duty days with COD Mobile. It's way easier than real COD, but it makes me feel better about myself, so there you go. Alright, that's basically everything there is to what's on my iPad right now. For those of you with similar iPad use cases, let me know what you thought of my setup down in the comments, and I hope this video helps some of you out. If you have other recommendations on how I can improve my iPad setup, would definitely love to hear from you too. Before we go, please consider liking this video and subscribing to the channel for more content like this. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video.